Hello, my dear students. So this video is about the continued part of a mind map, so through which we can remember in an easy way about the reactions and the reagents. Okay, when some questions will be asked in your competitive exam of 2020, okay, you can apply these methods. If you remember these reagents properly, then you can decide what might be the product you will going to get. So based on that one, I have planned and I have prepared this map. Okay, so where we have completed alkanes, its preparation and its reactions. Okay, and based on that one, we have discussed some of the questions as well. Okay, so you can just go through the link given below, so just to check regarding the alkanes. Okay, so in this video, I'll just complete the preparation of alkenes and their reactions, as well as the preparation of alkynes and their reactions. Okay, so let us go with the first part, that is the preparation of alkenes. So as I told, it's a simple way of remembering everything. Okay, and one more point, even I have mentioned you in the previous video, that if you remember the reagents, okay, you can understand what its role over here. If the same reagent are applied in another reactions, okay, if you know the role of this reagents being used, then you can predict the product very easily. Okay, so now it's a preparation of alkenes, where the alkenes with a general formula CnH2n. Okay, so these are the methods through which I can prepare. Okay, and these are nothing but what the reactants I can use. Okay, now do concentrate here. The first one, let us go with the alcohol. Okay, when alcohol are treated with a sulfuric acid or aluminium oxide, any one reagent we can use at a mentioned temperature. Okay, when alcohol is treated with a sulfuric acid under 170 degrees Celsius, I can get alkenes. Okay, so this you will going to study in the second year with a mechanism, that is the acid, like a dehydrolysis, I could say. Okay, the dehydrolysis of alcohol will results in the formation of an alkene. Okay, so where H2SO4 is well known as a deprotonating agent or dehydrating agent. Okay, yes, that is one. So instead of the sulfuric acid, you can use aluminium oxide as well with a mentioned temperature. Okay, when alcohol is treated with any one of these reagents, I can get the alkenes. That is one method. Okay, so next one is this one, sodium or potassium salts of a dicarboxylic acid. Okay, please do remember, sodium or potassium salts of a dicarboxylic acid means you will be having a two carboxylic group over here. Okay, so this is how sodium or potassium salts. Okay, so this is the dicarboxylic acid. When it undergo electrolysis, that is Kolbe's electrolysis, that results in the formation of alkene. So you have to remember here, it's a dicarboxylic acid. If the monocarboxylic acid undergoes Kolbe's electrolysis, it will going to give what? The alkene. So that we have discussed in the previous video. Okay, so please do remember, this is dicarboxylic acid containing two carboxylic group. Okay, that is the second method. And the third method is like, alkynes can be converted into alkenes. Okay, alkynes with a triple bond, okay, which is unsaturated, can be converted into an alkene by how? By the hydrogenation method. Okay, where the hydrogen will be added to the triply bonded carbon atom, so that it gets converted into alkenes. Okay, in presence of a palladium over carbon. So do remember, this is a catalyst, or hydrogen over palladium in presence of a carbon. Okay, this is one. Or else we can use sodium in liquid ammonia. Okay, so please do remember this reagent, sodium in liquid ammonia. So the process can also be known as a reduction, like addition of a hydrogen takes place to the alkynes to give alkenes. So can I take this like a reducing agent over here, sodium in presence of a liquid ammonia or hydrogen over palladium carbon can be taken as a reducing agents over here. Okay, alkynes are reduced into alkenes in presence of any one of the reagent. The special reducing agent you are seeing here is the sodium with liquid ammonia. Okay, I hope It is clear. Now let us move to this, that is alkyl halide. Okay, so this students, this is very very important. Okay, so compulsory questions will appear based on this one. Okay, so when I discuss the questions and answer, you will get to know how exactly it will come. So when alkyl halide treated with alcoholic potash, okay, when alkyl halide treated with alcoholic potash, that definitely gives alkenes. Okay, so the process here is dehydrohalogenation. D means the removal, hydro means the hydrogen, halo means halogen. So removal of hydrogen halide from the alkyl halide gives the respective alkene. So one of the famous method, and repeatedly the questions will appear based on this one. So where you're going to apply the Morkonikoff's rule and anti-Morkonikoff's rule, some type of a rules you're going to apply here. Okay, so next one is these two processes, that is gem dihalide and the vicinal dihalide. If you know the difference, okay, these are also the alkyl halides, but presence of a two halogen on both the group over here. Okay, gem and vicinal will decide where exactly halides are present. Are they attached to the same carbon or they attached to the two carbons? Okay, based on that one, gem dihalide and the vicinal dihalide can be. So in case of gem dihalide, you could see the presence of halogen on the same carbon. So this carbon is attached with a two halogen. Okay, such type of halides are called gem dihalide or geminal dihalide we'll going to call. Okay, whereas when it comes to vicinal dihalide, in case of a vicinal dihalide, what happens, each halogen atom is present at the each carbon atom. Okay, this is called vicinal. Okay, this is called vicinal dihalide. Okay, this is called gem dihalide. Okay, quite simple. What they are telling, when vicinal dihalide is treated with a zinc, okay, it results in the formation of a alkene. Do you remember when vicinal, in your exam, they're not going to say it as a vicinal dihalide. They will going to give the structure like this. Okay, you should understand, you should know what is vicinal, then you can answer it. Okay, so in what happens in case of a vicinal dihalide, the halogen atoms are present at the two different carbon. Okay, so when it is treated with a zinc, that results in the formation of alkenes, where the zinc chloride will come out and that gives the alkenes over here. Okay, same way when gem dihalide is treated with the excess of zinc, when gem dihalide is treated with the excess of zinc, okay, it results in the formation of alkenes. So both are same, only like excess of zinc is treated with an excess of gem dihalide, here with a one vicinal dihalide treated with a zinc to give alkenes. Okay, so these are what the method of preparation of alkenes. I hope it is clear. Okay, so let us move to the reactions of alkenes. Okay, so I'll going to put some of like a screenshot of these, the mind map. Okay, you can just note it down, you can practice it. Okay, yes, now you could observe the reactions of alkenes. Okay, you could see a number of reactions that alkenes can undergo. Okay, where you had to practice and you had to remember. Okay, yes, so just observe here, alkenes when treated with a hydrogen over nickel, okay, that gives alkenes. Okay, quite a reverse of the reaction it is. Alkenes which are unsaturated when treated with a hydrogen, or it undergoes hydrogenation, addition of a hydrogen, or I could say reduction, okay, it results in the formation of what? The alkanes. So in many reactions we could find the application of this one. So it will set in your mind that hydrogenation means either hydrogen over nickel, hydrogen over palladium, or hydrogen over platinum will definitely will going to appear. Okay, so alkenes gives alkanes. Similarly some more reactions are given here. So let us go here. Alkenes when treated with a water, Okay, alkenes when treated with the water, which is called hydrolysis, addition of a water will go into say, okay. Alkenes when treated with the water and heated, it results in the formation of a alcohol. Okay, remol of a OH here results in the alkenes, and the reverse of that reaction results in the alcohol preparation. Okay, so one and the same method. So hydrolysis means addition of a water, dehydrolysis means removal of a water to give alkenes back. So these are like a simple reactions. Okay, next, alkenes when undergo polymerization. Okay, alkenes, the doubly bonded alkenes when undergo polymerization will give a polymer. So best example is polyethylene. Okay, polytetrafluoroethane, like number of examples you could give where the number of alkene molecule, okay, n number of alkene molecules, like which we going to call it as a monomers, undergo the polymerization, will form a long chain to form a polymer. Okay, this is a simple method. Next one is when alkenes treated with a hydrogen halide. Okay, when alkenes treated with the hydrogen halide, it will undergo hydrohalogenation to give respective alkyl halide. So dear students, it is quite simple. So what we discussed over here is, just observe, in the preparation of alkenes, alkyl halide treated with the alcoholic potash to which undergo dehydrohalogenation, that is a removal of a hydrogen halide here. When the same alkenes, okay, when the same alkenes treated with the HX, okay, it will undergo what? Hydrohalogenation, that is addition of this hydrohalogen to this alkenes to give RX. The removal of the hydrohalogen will give the respective alkenes. So reverse of the same reaction. So that is quite simple here. Okay, so we have completed this three, and next comes, this is like, these are like a different reaction that you need to concentrate over here. Okay, so here when the alkenes are treated with the acidified potassium permanganate, quite simple, when alkenes treated with the acidified potassium permanganate or potassium dichromate, that results in the formation of ketones or carboxylic acid. Okay, quite simple, where this potassium permanganate and the dichromate are the well-known common oxidizing agents. Okay, when alkenes treated with any one of this in a warm condition will give ketones or carboxylic acid. Okay, so the next one is when alkenes treated with a ozone, which we're going to call it as a ozonolysis, the oxygen where the three oxygen atoms will be there, which forms a ozone, will undergo lysis, means the break. Okay, that results in the formation of a carbonyl compounds. Okay, first it results in the formation of ozonide, and followed by treatment with the zinc and the water, it gives carbonyl compounds. Carbonyl compounds means either it might be ketones or carboxylic acid or aldehyde. Okay, so specially we're going to get either ketone or aldehyde when treated with the ozone. So these two are compulsory reagents. Okay, so in any one of the questions, if it appears like one alkene will be given, in there they have given ozone and zinc and water. Okay, so you could think and you can answer either it should be aldehyde or ketones. Okay, that is how you need to apply this one. So the next one is when alkenes treated with a halogen. Okay, when alkenes treated with the halogen in presence of a carbon tetrachloride as a solvent, alkenes undergo halogenation, that is the halogen will be added over here to give respective 1, 2 dihaloalkanes. 1, 2 dihaloalkanes, both the halogen will be substituted to this alkenes to give 1, 2 dihaloalkanes. So quite simple. Next is when alkene treated with the hypohaloacids, we're going to call. When alkene is treated with the hypohaloacids, it results in the formation of a haloalkanol. Haloalkanol means the compound containing the halogen as well as the alcohol group. Okay, so this we will going to discuss when I'll take the questions. Next, alkenes when treated with a diborane. this you have studied in the second year. Actually, alkenes when treated with a diborane, okay, this results in the formation of a alcohol, where the high yield of alcohol can be obtained from this hydroboration and oxidation method. Actually, this method is called hydroboration and oxidation method, B2H6 followed by the presence of peroxide. Okay, so this is alkenes in presence of a diborane followed by the hydrogen peroxide will give respective alcohol. Similarly, I can get the alcohol by treating alkenes with a sulfuric acid. Okay, quite simple. When alcohol is treated with a sulfuric acid, that gives alkenes. Okay, when alkenes treated with a sulfuric acid followed by the hydrolysis will give respective alcohol. Okay, and the last method is when alkenes treated with a cold alkyl potassium permanganate. Okay, so you can just check over here. Here it is a warm acid potassium permanganate. Here it is a cold alkali potassium permanganate. Alkali means this potassium permanganate is prepared by using a base or alkali. Where here potassium permanganate is prepared by using what? The acid. Okay. When alkenes treated with a cold alkali potassium permanganate, which we're going to call it as a Bayer's reagent, the question might appear, concentrate. Okay. So Bayer's reagent, that gives what? Alkane 1, 2 diol. Alkane 1, 2 diol. Okay, so these are all the methods of the preparation of alkenes as well as the reactions of alkenes. So we will going to use this mind map while solving some of the previous year questions, then it will become very easy to apply and how it you can practice over it. Okay, so just make a chart like this. Okay, you can paste in your room or somewhere. Okay, so if you go on seeing this one, because there is a lot of time for your competitive exam, if you think, okay, if you use each one of day, then you can practice it daily. Each map you can practice on each day, then it becomes very easy to remember all the reagents and the reactions. Okay, so this completes the alkenes and the reactions and